Okay, so we've got this new technique that we just learned of how to hash things, and we're going to use this in our cookie to prevent people from cheating. Remember, we had that example where it kept a count, and we want to use hashing to verify that that count is valid. And the algorithm is going to look something like this. So instead of just saying set cookie visits equal 5, which anybody can edit, we're going to add a hash to this. So we're going to send something like this instead. Set cookie equals 5. We're going to add something on the end of this, so we'll add a comma, and then we're going to add a hash of the value here, 5, so that a would-be cheater can't forge a cookie without knowing what hashing algorithm we used. So we send this cookie with 5 followed by, our hex string, which A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. It'll be whatever the output of our hash was. When we receive this cookie from the browser, when we receive this 5, followed by our hash, what we're going to do is we're going to break this apart into two pieces. This will be like our value, and this will be our hash. We're going to hash this value and check to see if it equals this hash. And if it does, we know this value hasn't been tampered with. And if it doesn't, we know the cookie's invalid and we can throw it out. So our code's going to look something like this. We split apart the cookie value based on this comma into two parts, value and hash. And then we rehash the value, and if it matches the one we sent, we know that our cookie hasn't been tampered with.